Hello, people of the internet. I am Solarak Dragon, and this is Dark Souls 2 once again. When we last left off, we had cleared through the Royal Rat Vanguard, and I would just like to note, while I can't put a screenshot up beside this, the gravestones in that area did in fact change. They were not rats at first. They were actual, like, ruined tombstones, so that's more than a little bit freaky. Anyways, after we did that, we gathered a bunch of items throughout the area, and now we are progressing deeper and deeper into the depths. I'm going to keep the cat ring equipped just in case. Ooh, a human effigy. That'll make up for the one that we wasted back in the last episode. Which way to go? Which way to go? I want to go there. We overjumped it. Oh, that's what all those bloodstains were there for, wasn't it? All those people overjumped it as well. Wow. Okay, so note to self, we come at that from an angle next time. Alright, I'll come back to you guys when I'm there again. Alright, people, I'm back, and I decided that this time, instead of trying to make the jump over there, I'm gonna go the much safer route and just climb down to there, because I don't want to lose my souls again, because that was just completely ridiculous that I just lost them last time. And I'm just checking to see if there's any items over here as well, because you never know. Alright, I don't see anything right now, so down here, there's an item. So how are all of my watchers doing today? I hope you're all doing fine. And it's still the same day for me, still Sunday, though it's a little bit later in the day because I stopped to get myself some dinner, and of course, with dinner comes dessert, some chocolate moose tracks ice cream, yum. That's delicious, so chocolatey. I remember, it's not the most chocolatey thing I've ever had. The most chocolatey thing I've ever had would probably be when there was chocolate moose tracks. One of the first times I had it, I added like chocolate cake donuts that you could get from Walmart or Hostess. Hang on, token of spite. What is that? Proof of defeating another world's master. Token recognizing that the owner has traveled worlds to defeat others. When used, you are more likely to summon invaders from other worlds for a short period of time. Simply carrying these tokens shows the bitterness of the grudges the holder has accumulated. Alright, well, anyways, so at the bottom of it, I put down chocolate cake donuts. I drizzled some chocolate syrup on it. After that, I proceeded to, put some chocolate moose tracks ice cream on top of it, drizzled more chocolate syrup on top of it, and ooh, yep, these statues can shoot you, so you want to take them out. And I think it just said we entered them. Where did that say we entered? I forget. Let's see if we can get it to show up again. Because I completely... Was that a chest back there? Well, yeah, we already opened the chest. Duh. And I had chocolate milk with it, and it was so chocolatey, so sugar filled, but like I could not fall asleep for a while after I drank that and ate all of it. That was so good. But I'm not doing that again because I do not want to get a cavity or anything like that. I'm lucky I didn't the first time. Anyways, this area is actually one of the few areas that I will be using a torch. Boom, baby. We lose our left hand weapon, but we have an hour of torch time because we've used it so sparingly. Alright, then. Let's see. Where do we want to drop first? There's a lot of backtracking for this area if you want to get everything. And since I'm a completionist, I do. Alright, nothing further this direction. Go up. Do we want to go there? Should we drop there? Let's go up here first. Nope, he hit me. There's some more of those guys that we first saw in the Grave of Saints. Nothing that way. Yeah, you can see how much the torch is pretty much needed in this area. It's the only way to make some... Oh, shit, that was close. As I was saying, it's the only way to make some safe landings, and here's a brazier where we can light it, so we will be able to light the torch at a later time. Dang it! Yeah, these guys are gonna come up after me. We're going one-handed style now. We've abandoned the way of two hands, and we're down to the way of one. Oh, can we use... Nope, we can't use the torch as a weapon. I thought we might be able to, but we can't. He drops a poison throwing knife. Not a chest we can open. Oh boy, that sounds like a really big dog. You're hearing that too, right guys? Like some panting or something. Okay, message. Visions of treasure in short jumping. Okay, so it looks like we may have to go that way. There's a treasure all the way at the bottom, but I'm not gonna risk that. Because I very much doubt I'd survive the fall, but it looks like this is the way we gotta go. So here we go. Jump! Blazy! Oh, he has a weapon! Good thing we took him down quickly. And let's light this one up. But yeah. I love... In case I didn't mention it in a previous video, I do love my chocolate. Favorite dessert item ever. I mean, who doesn't love chocolate? It's so good. Armor ahead, then poison. Interesting. Shut off our torch for now. Ow! I forgot these things can only be broken like that. Alright. Oh, shoot, it poisoned me. That one on the ground's a poisoner too? Alright, inventory. We should have probably equipped these on our hot bar. Okay, how much health did we lose? Oh my, we almost died from the poison there. Yeah, let's put them on our hot bar now. Just so that doesn't happen again. Open? It's locked. So whatever's in there, we can't get to it right now. Lovely. And I have no idea how to get to it either. That's not good. But we can keep moving. Yes, if you light these braziers or brazers or whatever they're called. I think they're brazers, actually. I'd have to look that up, the spelling up to be positive, but you can then use them to light your torch at a later point in time. There's an item in that. I want to see what's over this way first. Another brazier or whatever it is called. Light it up. Light it up. Light it up. Light it up. I'm not copywriting. Alright, we can't make that jump, I can tell you that much. We could go down there, but this is the safer way. We want to be careful of those, because those look like we would fall right through. Is there anywhere else we can go? Nope, yep, right here. Okay, so we made it much safer. Whoa, that's a dog thing. And it hits like a truck. It hits like a truck. It hits like a truck. Let's move. Drink, drink, drink. Okay. It's taken down. Good. We really need both of our hands to deal with that guy. Because he was tough. We didn't attack fast enough with just one blade. And there's an item in this chest. What is it? This place again. Ooh, a dark pyromancy flame and rotten pine resin. So let us take off the torch so it's not burning constantly. Now let's check out that dark pyromancy flame. Dark pyromancy flame. Flame catalyst used by pyromancers. Pyromancers rouse this flame to produce various fire arts. The flame rewards those with a thirst for power. The more hallowed one is, the stronger its effect. So spell power scales with hallowing. Alright, well, we don't generally stay a hollow, and we're not going to be using a pyromancy glove, because that would take up one of our weapon slots. Was there anything else here, actually? Forgot to check. Nope, that's all that was down here, so we go. We can climb up now. Hopefully we run into one of our lit torches. Excuse me, because I forgot to carry flame butterflies with us. Nope, there's a brazier that we can't light. Alright, he's done. And let's keep going up and up and higher and higher and higher. Let me think. What else can I talk about? I've already talked about how this week hasn't been the greatest, aka my horrible Wednesday. What else is there to say besides that? Oh, we almost dropped there. Soul of a Nameless Soldier, okay. I'm trying to think. I can't really think of much to talk about right now. I really need to keep conversation topics or something nearby me. Ooh. Yeah, if we do that, we can get to that brazier. Oh. Take out that son of a gun. Ooh. These are probably poison shooters as well. Take these out so we don't have to worry about them later. No! Oh god. I thought that was a death trap right there. Whew! Let me think. I already talked about how... I told you guys a while ago how we've gotten... I have a PS4 now. And, yeah, there's that. Though, I'm debating... No, wait, what am I saying I'm debating? That's not anything related to this, so... I don't know why I was about to mention it, but... gosh, I can't think of anything right now off the top of my head. We're gonna have to make this jump, though. Oh, no, 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 no! We fell. Again. Sorry about that. Let me think. When was the last bonfire? It was a while back. So I'll be back after I've gotten to that point again. So see you guys soon. Alright, people. I'm all the way back to here. So I figured I might as well start. Because we're... Okay, now I know. We're in the gutter. That's the name of the place that we're in right now. Okay, so that makes things a little easier. We know the name of the place we are in. Which means we can look up guides. Not really. No, I don't use guides right now. I played through a lot of this game already, like, before when it first came out. I just don't really remember too much about it, so, yeah. Oh. No, 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 no. Oh. Well, maybe not some no. It made us land right next to a bonfire. Okay, I'll take that. Because that provides a good amount of light. And now if we die, we don't have to worry about being all the way back before the Rat King and his creepy grave of rat statue things. Alright, and another thing is with bonfires, if you toggle with triangle or whatever your respective button is, you can light torches at them. Yay, woohoo! We can't get up there yet, I remember that much. There's a brazier over here. Ooh, there's an item in there. Let's see what's in there. Smash. Dung pies. Yum, yum. Who doesn't want to eat a pie made of dung? I'll tell you who. Anybody. Alright, we were going to go this way last time, and we have items over there. I don't think we can make that jump from over here, so... We'll take the long way to get our souls back. Then we'll just use a homeward bone and get back to that bonfire and get moving again. So now that we know what to do, we can do this a lot faster. Alright, and run, hop, skip, and a jump away. In fact, we don't need a second. We don't need a torch right now. This area is decently enough lit. Yeah. Oh, we don't want to go up the ladder because of these stuff we can't do right now. I want to smash these just because I don't remember which ones spit poison and which ones don't. Drop. Okay. We have the dog creature in here. So he's gonna go down to Chinatown this time. There we go. That's Chinatown for ya. Yep, that's Dark Souls Chinatown. Just laying right there on the ground. And you gotta be dead too for it to be Chinatown. Yep. That makes perfect sense. Yeah, I was thinking of something to talk about while I was on my way here. And I still hadn't come up with anything. I guess I might as well put this out. If you guys, like, wanna hear me talk more about my day or week or whatever, be sure to let me know, because Honestly, I don't know if you guys like hearing me ramble on about my day and life and the week between recordings. You might like it, you might not like it. Whatever you do, let me know. If you want to hear me talk more about games or something, then I'll talk more about games. I just need that feedback. I mean, I don't get a lot of feedback, and what feedback I do get, it's alright. Though, I don't think I actually mentioned this, and I wanted to when I had first gotten it. But, like 2 weeks ago or so, I had gotten my first, negative comment. It was like, I don't remember their name, but it was on one of my Minecraft Blood Runs Red, Running Red things, and he called me a Direwolf 20 wannabe. And for those of you that don't know, Direwolf 20 is a... That's why I wanted to use a torch. That's why I wanted to have a torch, damn it. I'm OCD about that kind of stuff, but I don't care right now. I'm just gonna go back to the bonfire. But, yeah, he called me a Direwolf 20 wannabe. And for those of you that don't know, Direwolf 20 is a reasonably popular YouTuber who does mainly Minecraft videos. And he has single-player series and multiplayer series. It's just, he's a really good Minecrafter. I've watched his series. I'm subscribed to him. He's really cool. But, I mean, I got a negative feedback, and he called me a Direwolf 20 wannabe. So, I mean, I guess I got my first troll. And, I mean, at first I was like, is this guy serious? Because he had made videos himself, but they're pretty much just insulting other YouTubers. And I was like, is he being serious, or is he like doing this to get me views or something like that? But I mean, he hasn't made a video about me yet, so I kind of think he might have been serious about me, about not liking my video, thinking I was a Direwolf 20 wannabe. Kill this thing. There we go. We want to drink a flask and get ourselves a torch. I had to unequip my torch because I did not want to die to that dog. Light the torch up. But yeah, so I got my first flame review then. Haven't really gotten any reviews since. And it's been really quiet on the review front, sadly. I wish more people would, like, give me some form of feedback, just like a good job, like this episode, just small things like that. Excuse me, be nice. Though, I mean, who knows? Kingdom Hearts is a fairly popular game. I might get some feedback from those videos, since I do plan on doing every Kingdom Hearts game that I have access to, which is all the ones on the PS3, so a total of 4 games, I think, since 2 of the 6 that come with the whole 1.5 and 2.5 things are just, like, cutscenes galore, and I don't think I can legally publish that as a video, because that's not my gameplay or whatever, but, yeah, it's up here. Oh, that one spit at me. It was suspended in the air. Want to be careful of that one, I guess. Another brazier to light. And we can go down here now. Whoop. See whoop. Alright. We got a couple of these guys coming in. Gonna have to be careful. Ouch. We do hit a bit hard, but nothing we can't handle. Throwing knife and a large soul of a nameless soldier, so not bad altogether. What else is there here? We can't go up there, though I imagine that we will eventually. There's a chest up there too. Nope, we can't dive down there, sadly. That's why I left. Come on. Oh, no. Okay. I was afraid he was gonna like attack me. Where did he come from? I didn't see him behind the other one. Guess I am getting blind. But, yeah. Some feedback is always appreciated, even if it's negative. That's why I appreciate that guy for giving me some feedback, even if it was just a hate comment. Because it was my first, yay! Everybody loves having their first stuff, most of the time. But yeah. A life gem, that's cool. What to talk about now, though? Let's not rest at the bonfire. I don't need the dog things respawning on me. Those things are so painful to deal with. Just use that life gem we got instead. There we go. And, yep. Go down here. Ooh. Oh, lag. We had a brief, maybe not so brief, lag spike. Ooh. This could be bad. I'll come back when this is settled. Nope, I guess it's settled now. Or not. Come on, lag, stop. Please stop with the lag. Especially if there's an enemy coming right ahead of me. Oh, whoa, 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 ah! Okay, I will come back to you all once this lag has settled down. Alright, people, I'm back. It seems that whenever I do get lag spikes, I just have to stop recording, and then it'll immediately stop. I'm not sure if it only is gonna start... Oh, we got a doggy here. I'm not sure if it's gonna start spiking only, like, when I reach a certain amount of time having recorded something, or anything like that. And it might just be Dark Souls 2, because I didn't really have that problem. Oh, come on. No, no, no. Horrible time, horrible time. Bad, 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 bad. Okay. I don't know if you guys all saw that, but I got a serious lag right when I started facing this dog. I'm gonna cut and come back. Hopefully you guys can actually hear this audio. Alright, hopefully it's settled down with the lag right now. I mean, I don't know how much of it's gonna be in the last video, but... Oh, or in this video, but... When I first came over here, there was a dog thing, and as soon as I entered this area, it just started lagging, like, horribly, horribly wrong. I couldn't even see what was going on, it was so bad, and it's picking up again. Damn it. Okay, yeah, this is bad. Why do you lag so bad right now? Okay, the rate this lag keeps coming back and forth is ridiculous. See? We're already getting lag spikes here. And I have no idea what is causing it. I know it's computer side too, because when I'm switched to my TV, it doesn't show the lag. It's like seriously playing perfect condition. So it's gotta be my computer or something. I don't know what's wrong. Whenever I stop recording, the lag lets up. Ouch. But other, I can't stop recording if I want to put all this on YouTube. In fact, I'm pretty sure the audio in this video is going to be jumbled up at parts because the lag is just that bad. I mean, maybe it's the darkness or something that's causing the lag? I honestly have no clue. I have never had this bad of lag before in this game. Okay, we could have gone up over there. In fact, yeah, let's head that way. See what's up over here first. Oh, there was the lag again. I don't know, maybe it's the varying light levels or something? I honestly have no clue. It's annoying as hell, though. Because it's like I'm jumping. Alright, this is a safe chest. Good, because I don't think I could deal with it if it wasn't. And inside is three black fire bombs. Okay. Alright, nothing more up here. So let's go down the ladder. Yeah, maybe it's the torches that are giving me the lag. I mean, yes, I had some lag earlier when I started recording, but... And it was pretty bad, but... I don't know. I really gotta figure this out. I didn't have these troubles when I was playing Kingdom Hearts, but now, though... It's kind of ridiculous. hopefully, if I ever become a big YouTuber, then I won't have to worry about these problems, because I'll have a super good computer and shoot the dog thing. And a jumper. Yeah, this is another thing that I had to deal with that you guys might not end up seeing, because the lag was just, so bad at that point in time. Alright. Whoa! Ow! He clawed me from there. Should be able to take him down. And the dog thing is dead. I said to drink the flask, dang it. Alright. Let's head back this way. And get us a torch lit again so we can light up there. Dang it. Okay, that was a bit lag spike there real quick. Why is it doing this? Really? Maybe we'll figure it out eventually. I'm trying to decide where we want to go after this. We've been that way. Nothing further up this way, though we could drop down here, I suppose. Maybe we came from down, duh. Alright, so we're going across this bridge. There's probably a bunch of items that I'm missing out on, but this area is just so dark, it's hard to see things. I mean, I know there's a door up there that I can't get into right now. Though, if I remember correctly, it opens from the other side, and it might lead to a previous area. Can't be sure, though, so don't quote me on it, okay? Don't quote me on a lot of things, though. Ooh, I want to head over here, too. Oh, man, we're getting lag again. This will be a really bad place to lag, if that's what I remember. Is it what I remember? Not there. I can't see if it is or not. Ouch. Break that. Oh, shoot. My sword's at risk. I gotta repair it. Good thing I have barely... Oh, shoot. Shoot. That was close. Like, dangerously close. As I was saying, it's a good thing I haven't used a repair powder yet, even though I only have a very few of them. Alright, let's equip our other sword. And it's a lot. The lag seems like come really heavy whenever I switch light levels. Okay, so this isn't the one area that I thought it was. It's a different game entirely. Whoa, he did some heavy damage to me. Now let's drink this flask then. Attack chest, make sure it doesn't... It isn't a mimic, even though it is a metal chest. You never know. And a Wicked Eye Great Shield. Let's check that out. Alright. A great shield with an unsettling design, covered in the prints of countless hands. The true origin of the shield is unknown. No amount of polishing can clear its face of mysterious handprints. Well, if it's that handprint is really the only one on it, then I can tell you where the shield came from. It came from the Dark Brotherhood, which would mean this all takes place in the realm of Tamriel, or the Elder Scroll universe, for those that are less in the know. Ooh, we got a dog thing down there and a fog gate, but I do not want to risk that fog gate. I'm gonna keep exploring a bit, see if I miss anything. I don't think I've been down there yet, so that's something, that's somewhere to consider falling. There was nothing down over that, so here is one. So we'll drop it back. Yeah, let's drop here. See what we find. Okay, that doesn't come alive on us. So far, we got a brazier here, which we can light up. I know, I'm just pretty much saying what I see right now, but that's what commentating usually is, unless you have, like, some extra knowledge about this place, and quite frankly, I don't, though I do have to say, it reminds me a lot of Blighttown with how rickety everything is, and of course, this is just gonna lead us right back to there, although there is that lifting area. Whoa. Poison spitters right there. And that's where we gotta jump to. Oh boy. Whoa! That was some heavy lag there real quick when I made that jump. And we need to use this. I know I have them on my hotbar. I should have just used it from there, but I wasn't paying. I was afraid that lag was gonna last a lot longer than it did. Let's use these life gems instead of wasting our last flat. Sorry, I knocked my mic there. Let's use a life gem instead of using our flask. Oop, there's a bonfire up there. That's good. Though it also could be bad because it means that we're closing in on a dangerous area and there's still more to explore around here. Alright, let's light the bonfire first. I like how the bonfire area, like just the immediate area around the bonfire is so Nice. I mean, it's a perfect circle of stones, a layer of dirt, and a sword that's just sticking up out of the ground right there. Like, no damage, no wooden ricketiness. It's just a perfect bonfire right there. I don't think I can go anywhere from here. Well, I have to, otherwise why would they put a bonfire there, but I can't recall where, how to go in. Oh, there we go. Now I remember. Whoa, lag, lag, lag. Yeah, I definitely think it might be the light levels that are messing with me right now. Whoa. That was close. Because, when the light levels, like, are not bad, like, right now I'm not getting much lag, but when I go into areas that would change the light levels drastically, or when I, unequip my torch or look into really dark areas like down, it just hits horrible. Alright, we have the dog thing over this way, which you're gonna take down. There's all these ladders here, but there's still more to explore in this place, so I am not going to be taking these ladders down, even though that is the proper way to progress. Ooh, our poison is really high. Alright, we got the dog thing over here, which we want to take down. Let's take out those first. Oh, just to be safe. Alright, total darkness. Yeah, see, the lag is pretty low right now, when it's pretty dark. Ouch. This thing does damage, like, great. No! What? It was swiping in front of it! It didn't even hit me! How did it hit me? Darn it! Grr. I didn't want to die there. But that dog thing, it doesn't get staggered at all, and it hits from every angle. I mean, if you're in front of it, it bites its claws at you. If you're at its side, its claws apparently hit you. And as you might have seen earlier, when you're behind it, its back claws hit you. So it's like a lose-lose situation with that thing. Come on. Why am I not locking on? Let me lock on there. That was weird. We got that one with the backswing. Ooh, I missed this item. And it was just some dung pies. So nothing really too big of a miss. Alright, no more enemies up here. Ouch! But spit at me. You spit at me. Alright. Let's take down Mr. Doggy here. Oh, I wanted to pick up my lost souls. And use the life gem. Shoot. Lag spikes are no fun. So let's not share with anyone. One more. Down, bad doggy. You stay down. You're in Chinatown now. Alright, poison arrows. 20 of them. Not bad at all. We could go that way. Let's go this way, because this way has these things that want to die for me. Oh, that's the thing. Alright, I need to get a torch. First I want to check what's over here, because I don't remember. And there's nothing over there. So, let us get a torch. Real quick. Thank goodness the bonfire is just over here. And we'll light up that brazier over there, and then we will examine what is in there. You did see some moving objects, and it was fairly foggy in there. Yeah, see, when I lit the torch just there, I got a massive lag spike. It's really weird. Hopefully when I get to more well-lit areas, it won't be anywhere near as bad. Though, knowing my luck, it very well might be. And there we go. We got some weird mushroom things. I don't know what these are called, actually. Like this. Set light to there. And unequip the second torch. Unequip the torch. Ouch. Ouch! Lag. Much lag. Not good. Wow. Drink the flask. Okay. That one's dead. As is that one. Though, it doesn't really matter, considering we... Ooh. That's a big ball. That's a big thing in there. Really big. Hello? I forget, is this thing... I forget if this thing's not aggressive, but... Look at it. It's like the Insect Queen from Yu-Gi-Oh! Card. It looks so much like it, though it keeps, like, emitting some sort of noxious gas that I really don't want to stand in. That's why I'm attacking this leg instead of the big thorax. Because I honestly do not know what that gas is doing. And the big bug's dead. Any other enemies in here? Any? No. It only dropped a poison moss for me. But there's two pots with dead people in them. And I'm seeing at these things, really? There we go. And one of them had another poison moss and three more poison moss. So all in all, that was fairly worthless. Though I think it might have given me a good amount of souls now that I mention it. Anyways, I think I might be getting close to the wrapping up for this video, though I'm not entirely sure. Let's go to the bonfire, rest at it, and go back to some earlier areas. I'll try and find some new areas, and I'll come back to you if I do find any more in this place. So, see you all soon. Alright, everybody, I'm back, and so far the only place I've found that I need to go is to drop down right here and see where this area leads me. And I am aware that this video is longer than half an hour by a bit so far, like only a couple minutes right now, what I saw, but I'm gonna keep going because I want to see, I want to finish up this area a bit more before I call it an episode. Ooh, we can go around this way. See, the lag seems to get really bad whenever I look into just areas of pitch black darkness. If I look at the textured stuff, it's alright. But when I look at the dark areas, it's just terrible. Come on, I said set light. I think we might be able to jump down there, but I'm not going because that does look like a stupid risk to take. Right now, though, we can go in here. Alright. Put this on up. See what else is on this floor. I'm pretty sure the ground's gonna collapse somewhere on this area. Okay, we got a... Ooh, the tattered set. This environment's really not the best to, show off some new armor sets, so we'll wait till we're in a better lit area. AKA beginning of the next week's video, because I'm going to be needing to stop by Majula soon to get myself some level ups. Okay, there's a ladder that way. Thing that can be lit right here. Oh, there's a string. There's a whole conga line of enemies waiting for me. And we got that thing hanging there that's going to try and poison me. But we just roll right on by. Okay, so I knew they were both alive. Why wouldn't it let me hit? Maybe the lag was just bad. The shadows there. That might also be contributing to the lag. Shadows. Alright, there we go. Inside this chest we find a Ring of the Evil Eye. Well, too bad we got a Ring of the Evil Eye plus one already. Oh, hello, sir. I said die, sir. Hello. There we go. Keep dying for me. Excuse me. Got burped right now. And what's up this ladder, I wonder? Pretty long ladder. Pretty long. And it's a dark area, but I'm not getting much lag. Still getting those red lines, though. It looked like I had fixed them when I was watching through my Kingdom Hearts videos, but in this, it's like still very much noticeable, which I find very, very annoying. Alright, let's light this up. We should have some enemies popping up behind us. That's the nature of when you walk over dead things. They turn out not to be dead in this game. And this is Soul of a Proud Knight. Nice. Very nice. This guy was a jumper, I think, because his body dissolved. Bandit Great Axe. I think that might be part of the Tattered set, in all actuality. And let's light this up. We could drop down, but I'm not going to. Wait. Oh, no. Okay, I was about to say, you will not let me... You had best let me back up, because there was a ladder to go up. Whoa. Whoa. I got some massive lag just there. From my point of view, I just jumped to there at that point. Oh. I can zip line. I can zip line. Oh my god. Oh. Oh, yep, we can zip line. Whee! That was cool. That was cool, I admit it. I did not know that I could do that here. Wow, that was awesome. And where does this lead us? Lag Central. No, seriously, where? Okay, I guess we go down here and find out. Oh wait, are we all the way back at the beginning? Relatively, we are. Alright then. So I guess that must be everything that this area has to offer, except for going down that one, those multiple ladders, and going through that doorway. So I'm going to Homeward Bone, and I will start my outro. So I've been Solrak Dragon. I do hope that you've all my viewers have enjoyed this. If you have, or if you haven't, then leave me some feedback in the form of a like or a comment, positive or negative. It doesn't matter to me. If you want to check out more videos from me, then be sure to subscribe to my channel. And other than that, I will see you all next time. Have a most excellent day, everybody. Bye-bye.